हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
is being done
दिस सर्कुलेटरी मूवमेंट ऑफ वाटर इज कॉल्ड कन्वेक्शन करंट. दिस कन्वेक्शन करंट ऑल्सो हैपन इन एवरी टाइप ऑफ फ्लूड. आइदर इट इज ए वाटर मॉलिक्यूल और इट मे बी एनी गैसियस मॉलिक्यूल लाइक एयर. वट एवर मे बी द फ्लूड प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस अर्थ ऑल गेट्स हीटेड थ्रू दिस फिनोमिनन दैट इज कॉल्ड कन्वेक्शन. सो वी कैन से दैट द ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट फ्रॉम वन पार्ट टू ए अनदर पार्ट विद इन अ फ्लूइड और विद इन ए लिक्विड और विद इन ए गैस इट इज पॉसिबल थ्रू द सर्कुलेटरी मूवमेंट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ द गिवन फ्लूइड. And this phenomenon is called, or we can say that this process is called convection. Convection always perform in upward direction. It means convection current always, or we can say that the transfer of heat of a source by convection only in the upward direction means heat transfer in convection method only in upward direction. To understand more about this, let us see this experiment. Suppose that this is a candle. We burn this candle this produce a flame. And a boy put his hands in this direction, upward direction, and another hand in this direction means horizontal way like this, and one hand is upward direction. The hand put direct on the upper side of the flame, he feels more hotness in comparison to the another hand which lies just in the horizontal direction hand. It means energy produced by the flame or the air present near the flame, air molecules present near the flame, they gets heated and goes upward and the colder air molecules comes downward, So water molecules reach to the hand which is placed on the upward direction, they gets more energy in comparison to the another hand which present in the horizontal direction of the flame, because the air molecules get energy or heat, it becomes lighter in weight and they go upward irrespective of the surrounding place. That's why we conclude that air can transfer the heat of a source by convection only in the upward direction. This is the most important point. In convection method, heat is transferred only in upward direction. Next topic is how convection is possible in air. Convection in all in water already I have discussed in my last video. Today I will discuss more about the how convection possible in air or gases. Suppose that here this is a room, and within the room we installed a room heater at the corner of the room. This is the room heater. After switching on the room heater, we observe that the elements present in the room heater, they gets energy from the electricity, and what air present inside the room the air molecules which are present nearer to the heating element, they gets heat from the room heater, and after getting this heat they becomes lighter in weight and goes rises upwards. After certain period of time, the colder molecules which present inside the room, the colder molecules are heavier in weight, they comes down and they also get heat from the room heater and they also become hotter. And after certain period of time, all the air present inside the room gets heated and finally our room is heated by this convection current, because the circulation of air molecules is also takes place inside the room, and this circulation of air molecules is called convection current. So briefly we can say that our room is heated because of this convection current. Set up inside the room by the air molecules. So we can say that air is also a poor conductor of heat as like water, but it is a good convector of heat. Convector and conductor both are different phenomena. A good convector of heat, because transfer of heat in air is only possible through the convection method, not by the conductor method, because air and water both are the fluid, and the molecules present in air and water both are not fixed at a place, and they can move from one place to another place easily. That's why air is a good convector of heat, not a good conductor of heat. So because in conduction method there is no transfer of molecules or movement of molecules from one place to another place is possible, that's why in air and water heat transfer cannot be possible through the conduction method. Due to convection possible in air, here arising two wind blowing concept, that is called blowing of sea breeze and land breeze. Due to the convection possible in air, here arising two concepts or two ideas, we can say that the blowing of sea breeze and blowing of land breeze. When we can say sea breeze is blowing, and when we can say land breeze is blowing. This is depend upon the two factors. One is land and another is water. To understand more about the sea breeze and the land breeze blowing, first of all we have to need here to understand more about the absorbing capacity of absorbing and releasing capacity of heat of the land and the water, because the absorbing and releasing capacity of land is different from the absorbing and releasing capacity of heat of water. And this idea leads to the rising of temperature difference between the absorbing of heat of land and the absorbing of capacity of heat of water. So, what are the absorbing capacity of land? Land, they absorb heat more faster and release heat more faster in comparison to the water. Means land absorbing or releasing heat capacity is more faster than the water, and this temperature difference leads to the transfer of heat from one place to another place, and due to this air is blown from land to water or from water to land. It depends upon the daytime and nighttime of the whole day. So let us understand what is sea breeze. Means blowing of sea breeze. Blowing of sea breeze only it is takes place in daytime. Why it is takes place in daytime? Let us understand it. Suppose this is a land. And this is water, or we can say that coastal area, and this is sea. In daytime, sun is rises. This is sun in rises. And due to sun rising in the daytime, the land gets heated to a higher temperature much more quickly than the sea water, and the hot air present near the land rises upwards. Hot air rises upwards from the land. And the cool air, which is present over the sea, it moves towards the land. Cool air from sea moves towards the land . This is called sea breeze. In the daytime, land and water both gets heated, but land gets heated to a higher temperature much more quickly than the sea water. Because of this, the air present near the land gets more heat and goes upwards, and the cooler air, which is present over the sea water, they move towards the land. And the blowing of air from the sea towards the land is called sea breeze. What is sea breeze? The blowing of wind from the sea towards the land is called sea breeze. The blowing of wind from the sea towards the land is called sea breeze, and sea breeze happens in the daytime. In the same way, land breeze is also blowing. So we can say that blowing of land breeze . Suppose that this is a land area and this is sea water. In the daytime, night time, what happens? the land cools much faster than the seawater. Due to which the land becomes cool very quickly, but the sea water remains warm. And so, during the night, the hot air over the sea rises upward, hot air over the sea water rises upwards, and the cooler air from the land moves towards sea, and this is called land breeze. It means land breeze is happen in the night time and day breeze happen in the daytime, and it is totally depends upon the absorbing and releasing capacity of heat of the land and the water. So what is land breeze? How can we define land breeze? Land breeze, we can define that the blowing of wind from the land, the blowing of wind from the land towards the sea is called land breeze. Okay, thank you. Next time I will discuss with a new topic, which is radiation. Thank you.